Hey guys, Gokesum for the One here, and welcome back to another Leaf Green walkthrough episode. In this part, we'll be going down the next route and making it to the next city. Now, once you go through Lavender Town, which we did last episode, there's not that much to do in this town, so just travel on to the next route. You didn't exactly need to follow me through last episode looking around, but I just wanted to show off for a thing. But the next route is gonna have a few trainers on it, and there's also a few patches of grass where you can catch a few Pokemon. But we're gonna fight this lass right here, and she has two actually super strong Pokemon on her team. We haven't seen this yet. She's got two level 22 Clefairies. I don't know if they're both female or not, but I'm confident that our Robin could go up to level 24 after this battle here. And also, why would you go for follow me? Okay guys, if you guys don't know what follow me is, it's such a dumb move that I don't know why they put it on single battle trainers, I guess you could call them. Not double battle, but follow me, if you're in a double battle and you have two Pokemon on the other side of the field, if one Pokemon on that other side of the field uses follow me, you will have to hit that one Pokemon, because it pretty much, it's a magnet, that move. You have to hit that Pokemon that uses follow me. So the other Pokemon, if it has low health, it'll be safe. But in single battles, it's a waste of a move, because there's no other Pokemon to save. It's just you being like, hey, I'm a free target, let me hit you. But it looks like we took out this Clefairy is quite swiftly, and I'm gonna switch out. Actually, we have to train up our Chaotic and Roshi, which we actually are able to do now because we are full health. In Rock Tunnel we had some problems here and there, but since we're healed up, we'll be able to do that. Now the next Pokemon trainer you're gonna verse is Gamer Rich. We've got that old people swag right here, the old people gamer. I don't know, I find it offensive still that they made gamers old. Not all gamers are old. I'm only 15 here, so anyways, we're gonna fight this trainer, and he has two fire types on his team, which are actually two fire types you'll be able to catch on this route. Growlithe and also Vulpix, both level 24 on his team. But if you want to catch one of these Pokemon, they'll be level 15 to 18, and in Leaf Green you could catch Vulpix, and in Fire Red you could catch Growlithe. You can't catch both of them in both games, because why would Pokemon do that? Then they're not going to be able to sell both copies. But we're going to take down this Vulpix right here and easily go up to level 27. No, I always misguess that. I always think I'm going to go up to a level, but it doesn't happen. I missed it by like 10 EXP points. But here are the patches of grass right here. Again, you can catch Vulpix and Growlithe. It's going to be a 20% chance to actually catch them. So, oh my god, spinners. When spinners are actually not doing what you want them to do. Usually when you have a spinner, you don't want them to look at you, but in this case, we want him to look at me. And he didn't look at me. I hate when the computer does that. It never does what you want to do. So, he's going to have a few Pokemon on his team this. I think it was a scientist. Is this a scientist? I'm pretty sure it was a scientist. But he's gonna have a Grimer, and then a Muk, all level 22. Muk is actually a super good Pokemon if you want a good poison type on your team. Super good physical attacker if you can get a few physical moves on it. I think Gunkshot is physical in this gen. I don't know for sure though. But Gunkshot on Muk, if it is, super strong move that I recommend putting on your Pokemon. Maybe Gunkshot's not even a thing in this gen, I don't know for sure. I never played competitive in this gen, so I don't know 100% which moves are physical and special and which moves are in the game. Because from gen 3 to 4, they actually changed some moves from physical to special. Which is kind of weird. I don't understand why Vine Whip, for example, is special in this game. You'd think, since you're hitting someone with a whip, it would be physical, but I guess not. And we didn't take him out? Come on, Muk. Muk is also pretty defensive if you want a good bulky attacking poison type on your team, but we're going to take him out right there. And oh, he has one more Pokemon left. I thought Muk was going to be sent out last, but I guess not. He's saving one of his weaker Pokemon for last. Wanted to maybe power through me, but wasn't going to happen. Going for that Rock Slide. I probably could have went for a Dig, but I guess it really doesn't matter, because we would have wasted, I think, 3 turns instead of 2. So this was a little bit of a faster route to go through that with a Rock Slide. but we're going to take down that trainer and get a few dollars from that. Now, again, this route has a lot of trainers on this route, and we're going to actually do our first double battle. So I'm going to switch out our Light Bulb right here for Roshi, just because I want to get Chaotic and Roshi out there for some battles. Just because, hey, they need some EXP points, and they're kind of low on my team. They're lower levels. So we're going to fight this last, and I think you guys saw that. I sped up the game for like half a second there on accident. I pressed the speed up button. But we're going to fight a level 22 Jigglypuff and Clefairy. We're going to get an Intimidate. I don't think that matters though, unless Jigglypuff has Pound or something, but it's not really going to affect anything. Now, Rock Slide is one of those moves that are super good in double battles because it hits both Pokemon. And if you have a stab move on, it's not really stab on Chaotic, but if you have a rock type, for example, I don't know, Onix, even Geodude if you really want to, that has Rock Slide, and there's flying types on that side of the field, you're most likely going to take them both out. But I think if you have, I don't know if this is a thing in Gen 3, but if you have a move that hits both Pokemon, it splits the damage. So Rock Slide would usually do full health to Jigglypuff, but instead it's going to do a little less. It's going to take him down to red health or something, or even only do half damage to him. But I don't know if that's for sure in this gen. It is a thing in later gens, but I don't know. But we're going to take down this Pokemon nevertheless. Easy sweep for my Pokemon. Have such strong Pokemon at this part of the game still. Can't believe I actually have this high of levels. Usually all my Pokemon are only level 21 or something like that because I grab 6 Pokemon at the beginning and I don't level grind. That's one problem you probably... I don't know if any of you guys have that problem, but I usually get that problem. And we're just going to go straight into this battle right here. I wanted to take my time and explain a few more Pokemon that were on the route, but we're gonna fight this next scientist right here. I guess I can explain some of the Pokemon that are on this route anyways, but he's gonna have one Pokemon on his team, so it shouldn't take too long. And it's gonna be a Koffing. Now, you can't go... I don't know if he has Levitate. I'm pretty sure he has Levitate, so if you're up against a Koffing or a Weezing, make sure you don't go for ground moves because it won't work. He has Levitate. The ability Levitate actually stops you from using ground moves on whatever Pokemon has the ability. So that's one super effective move that's going to go away for Koffing and Weezing, which is pretty nice for them because that makes them even more threatening to battle, but they're still weak against Psychic types and they're not really the greatest special defensive Pokemon in the world. But anyway, Super Nerd is going to go down, and I was supposed to explain some Pokemon that were on this route, but we had so much to talk about, Levitate and stuff, so I guess we weren't able to. We're going to fight this last, though, and this last actually has two Pokemon on your team, a Nidoran female and a Nidorina, which is going to be also female, of course, but we should be able to take these Pokemon out with Dig because they are poison types. But yeah, some Pokemon you can catch on this route, you've seen them before, actually. They're all going to be the same in both games, Leaf Green and Fire Red. You're going to catch Pidgey, Meowth, and, you can catch Pidgey, Meowth, and Ekans. Ekans is going to be a 20% chance, and Pidgey and Meowth are going to be a 30% chance. And they're going to be ranging around level 20 and 17. So, not too bad of a catch on this route. If you want to catch a Meowth, yeah, definitely do that. If you don't have a flying type yet, make sure you pick one up. Like, I'm telling you, you have to. If you don't have a flying type yet in this game, at this point in the game mostly, you should pick it up on this route. It's mandatory pretty much, because later on you get a HM which is Fly, and you're able to fly around the whole Kanto region, which is very useful actually. You don't want to be running back through caves and stuff and wasting all that time when you could just fly there in like 3 seconds, but we took that last down right there super easily with our Chaotic. Chaotic is actually gaining up levels fast, almost up to level 30. And our next trainer right here is going to have 3 level 24 Meowths. So it looks like the trainers are totally leveling up their game here. I guess kind of. Their Pokemons are leveling up, but evolution-wise, not the greatest in the world. The only person we've seen with a pretty decent Pokemon was the scientist Glenn, which had a Muk earlier on. But let's take down these Meowths. Meowth, I said this earlier, Meowth is a pretty good Pokemon, but Persian, on the other hand. Persian, super good special attacking Pokemon. Not really one of those Pokemon you would want to use in competitive, but in-game, it can learn a bunch of moves. You can teach it Dark Pulse, Thunderbolt, I think Flamethrower even, Hyper Beam if you want to. Actually, I don't know if it can learn Hyper Beam, but it has a wide variety of moves. So if you want to search up the moves you can learn, I'm pretty sure you can learn like most TMs and stuff. And if you want a Pokemon that has a lot of spread of moves, I guess, like he has a Thunder move, Electric move, a Ground move, etc., then you could definitely pick up Persian. One of those Pokemon I thought of actually picking up, but I thought maybe I'd be copying another Let's Player that's super popular for Leaf Green Let's Plays. So I didn't really want to do that. I didn't want to copy him. But Chaotic's going to take down all these Meowths, actually. I thought she had one more. Wasn't paying attention. Talking about Persian too much, fangirling over that Pokemon. But I think we have two more trainers or so. Yeah. Oh, no. We have three more, actually. I don't even know if this guy up here is a trainer. But we're going to fight this last right here. And this last is going to have a lot of Pokemon on our team. I don't think we've seen this much Pokemon on someone's team since, actually, I don't know if we've seen this at all. I don't think any trainers have had actually 5 Pokemon on their team. Later on, you'll fight a trainer with a bunch of Magikarps, but that's really it. Usually, trainers on routes don't have this much Pokemon. But they're super easy because she's gonna have all level 19 Pokemon, and they're all first evolution, I think, except for one Pokemon, which is gonna be Nidoran Male. But, actually, I think that might even be I don't even know if it's in the Nidoran Male. I think it might be its second evolution, or its first evolution. So, yeah, it might be its first evolution. But, anyways, I'm going to get off that, because I'm kind of getting confused here. And we're going to take out this Rattata. Go up to level 29, almost up to level 30. Come on, Chaotic, you can do this. Almost up there with the big boys. And then we only have to train up our Gyarados last. So, yeah, it looks like this is going to be the first evolution, so when I said Nidoran male earlier, I meant its second evolution, Nidorina. I didn't actually mean, or maybe it's Nidorino. Nidorino, yeah. I get confused between the two Pokemon because they're both so similar in names and kind of similar in the way they look, the female and male version, so yeah, I got super confused when I explained that there, but let's fight this next Meowth. Ooh, we're out of digs and rock slides. Doesn't matter, Slash is still a pretty decent move. So, Meowth is going to go down pretty easily there. Now, the final Pokemon you're going to fight is a Pikachu, which I actually still have to pick up Electric type for myself. I was thinking about this before the episode, where I'm going to do it, and I don't know exactly where I should. But yeah, just so you guys know, I am going to have an electric type on my team. A little bit of spoilers, but you guys probably guessed it, because why wouldn't I have an electric type on my team? We don't really have any Pokemon for, I guess we do for flying types, but that's only Chaotic, and Chaotic's not going to be able to keep doing this for long, because he only has 10 PP on Rock Slide. If we run out of Rock Slides in a row, we might have troubles here and there with flying types if we can't take them out pretty easily. Mostly against our rivals, which I think Gary, or Blue if you want to call him, or whatever you named him. I don't know what you guys named him. But yeah, he has a Pidgeotto and it'll evolve into a Pidgeot later on, so one of those Pokemon that we have to look out for. And if Chaotic dies from, I don't know, one of his, I don't know, I think Gyarados he has on his team, considering which starter we chose, then yeah, we're gonna have some problems there. But we're gonna fight this next trainer here, and he's gonna have two Grimers on his team, which we already took out one, and he's gonna have a level 24 Grimer. Oh my god, what do we go for here? We're out of moves because he went for a disable. We can't go for Poison Sting, not gonna do any damage. So Roshi, you're gonna come out again. Let's take out this Grimer. Don't die, please. I don't think he'll die from this Grimer, but you never know. Okay, he's gonna go for Harden, that's fine. Grimer again? Actually, what's the move? I think it's called Acid Armor or something. If you run it on your Muk, It's pretty good in-game, but in competitive, it can be pretty useful as well. If you want to make your Grimer in Little Cup, if you really want to do that, I don't know how many people play Little Cup, which is actually a tier from competitive Pokemon. But if you want to use a Muckin OU or something and give it Acid Armor, it's a pretty decent move, actually, to put on your Pokemon, because it raises your defense sharply, I think, so it's by like 2 or 3 points or so. So it's a pretty good move if you want to make your Pokemon bulkier. But let's fight this final trainer. I think this is the final trainer. We might actually have one more, and he didn't want to fight us, but hey, we got to fight him anyway. So he's gonna have 3 Pokemon on his team. He's gonna have a coffee. Yeah, guys, this looks like a coffee mug right here, but he's gonna have 2 coffings and a Grimer as well. All gonna be level, actually, his 2 coffings are gonna be level 22, and then his Grimer is gonna be level 23. So, yeah, we shouldn't have too much troubles. I think after Chaotic goes up to level 30, I'm gonna switch him out, just cause I don't want him to be too high of a level. I think level 30 is good enough for where we are in the game. And then we also have to level up our Roshi, like I've been saying this whole episode, but let's take down this Koffing right here, and level 30? Nice, okay. I didn't mispredict that this time. We got it right, went up to level 30, and just for this one battle, yeah, I think I'll just stay in with Chaotic. It doesn't really matter. I don't want to waste time switching out. I guess if I didn't stop and think there, it would have been the same amount of time as if I stayed in or thought or switched or not, but yeah, we're gonna take out this Grimer here with Slash pretty easily. And let me actually check. I think this is, oh no, we have 2 more trainers on this route still, so I actually was wrong about that. I didn't even think we would have 2 trainers. I wasn't even thinking that whatsoever. I thought maybe it was just 1, but since again Chaotic is level 30, we're gonna switch into our Roshi here. And this scientist actually has a few Pokemon that will be hard to take out for Roshi. I don't know if they have super effective, if they do have super effective moves, they don't have Thunderbolt or something, but he's gonna have 2 Voltorbs and a Magnemite, which Voltorb I kind of wanted to pick up before we went to Rock Tunnel, but I forgot to, so it was pretty much out of the question at that point. And we finally get to use our Dragon Rage here. You guys will see how powerful this move is. Look how much damage that does. This is exactly why Dragon Rage is pretty good, like, early on in the game and somewhat in this part of the game. It's not going to Oko every time, but it's going to two-shot pretty easily. So we will be able to take out these electric types nicely. And he's going to bring out his Magnemite next. I don't know how much HP. I think Magnemite definitely has more HP than Voltorb, but, or not. Magnemite's just gonna go down one shot there. Damn, I love Dragon Rage, such a good move. But he only has 2 more Pokemon on his team. Koffing level 20. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier, but he also has that. So if you have a ground Pokemon that you'd like to get a few EXP points here and there, then you can do that. I think a ground Pokemon would actually sweep through this whole team of the scientists right here, so you could pretty much just like get a bunch of EXP points. There's one thing I don't understand why people do this. When they're playing in-game stories, if, for example, a trainer has a water type, fire type, and then grass type, they'll choose super effective Pokemon against all of those Pokemon in their opponent's side of the field, and they'll get little EXP boosts right in here, but they won't get the amount of EXP that they would have if they just fought all 3 of the Pokemon with the same Pokemon. It just takes 10 times longer to level up, and yeah, it's just not the smartest thing to do in the world. If you guys are doing that, it's not a bad strategy, but it's just not the best strategy in the world. If you just battle a full team with 1 Pokemon, then you'll go up a level or something like that. It just levels up faster. But Roshi's going to go up to level 23 here, and I keep stuttering. This is one thing that a lot of Let's Players actually have, and I've noticed this. I don't know if you guys noticed this whatsoever. I might just be pointing this out and you guys weren't noticing, but it's super hard for a Let's Player to talk for like 10, 20 minutes or so, continuously at that, because you'll start slurring your words here and there because your mouth will start getting dry and stuff, and it's one of those things that I applaud Let's Players on. Not specifically me, but I mean like people who do this for their job, just because it's super hard to do continuously. But We don't have a antidote, so we won't be able to heal our poison. That kind of sucks, actually, but we're going to fight this next trainer right here, and these are actually newer Pokemon that we haven't seen, at least I don't think we've seen yet. Gamer Stan, we got that old man gamer. He's going to send out the Poliwag. The one and only Poliwag. I don't know why I said it like that, but he's going to have two level 22 Poliwags and a level 22 Poliwhirl. If we didn't pick up a Gyarados, this was going to be the other Pokemon that I wanted to pick up for a water type, because I love Poliwhirl's evolution line. It's one of my favorite things in the world. I want to go for a Dragon Rage, but I don't want to waste the PP. So we're just going to go for a Tackle. This should take him out. But yeah, I love Poliwags, Poliwhirl, whatever Pokemon you want to start with, the evolution line, just because Poliwrath was probably one of my first water types I ever got to like full evolve. Besides my starter, of course, which was Feraligatr, but yeah. And then Politoed also, such a good Pokemon competitive, super good for rain teams in VGC. If you guys want to run a rain team, definitely run Politoed, because he gets Drizzle as an ability and he's super bulky, so you could keep switching him in and out to reactivate that rain every 8 turns. If you have a Damp Rock on him, of course. But let's take down that Poliwag right there. And Poliwhirl's gonna come up next. Now we could use Dragon Rage right here. I don't understand why we take poison damage after when they switch in. It doesn't do that in the later gens, but in this gen it does. Poliwhirl is not going to go down in one shot, of course, but he's going to go for a Water Gun. I think that only did like 1 HP to us, so it doesn't matter, but the poison's still going to be doing a lot of damage to us. Poliwhirl is going to go down anyways, and we're not up to level 27. I really wish we were going to go up to level 27, just because we would have got a few more EXP points there. I don't think it would have mattered, because we still have a long way to walk, and Roshi is just going to die. Oh, I hate this poison thing. Okay, I'm going to run back and forth and kill Gyarados. That kind of sounds wrong, but I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay, the only reason I did that was because I don't think neither of us, neither you guys or me, wanted to deal with that noise. It's super annoying, and yeah, I just didn't want to deal with the noise, because I hate the poison thing in these gens. I think they only removed it in Gen 5, maybe even Gen 6 only, but yeah, I don't understand why they put that in there. We know they're poison, but you didn't need to put that noise. But anyways, once you come into this route right here, you weren't able to go through here. You had to go through the underground tunnel, so make sure you follow me, or this guard right here will stop you because he's thirsty. The road's closed because he's thirsty. It's so stupid. I don't understand that guard's logic, but yeah, that's dumb. But anyways, Route 7 right here is going to have the same Pokemon as the route before. Meowth, Pidgey, Oddish, and Growlithe, or Vulpix, depending on which game you chose. But the next city right here is going to be Celadon City, and there's a Team Rocket Grunt here, which is actually a hint for the next episode. But anyways, guys, I'm going to end off the episode right here. If you guys did enjoy, I'd really appreciate it if you told me what you like in the comment section down below, and also tell me something you didn't like, because I'd really appreciate the criticism that I can improve these episodes. I say this after the episode, it kind of gets repetitive, but you guys get the point. Anyways, if you guys like this video, shoot that like button with a comment.